and brief explanation of what shaking is and how to do it. So it's a very easy practice. It's kind of a standing meditation. You start with the feet about hip width apart. The feet should be straight, or perhaps the toes are a little bit curved in. If they're a little bit in, it opens up the lower back. Then just hands down, tip of the tongue touches the roof of the mouth. Try to feel it almost feels like a marionette string going up from the crown of your head upwards. It helps bring the posture up. You want the head to come up while the shoulders are relaxing down. Take a moment to scan your body. Just feel what different places feel like. If you have any tension anywhere, just make kind of a sensory map. And then after, usually take a few minutes at least to do this part. But after you take some time to feel your body, then raise up a little bit onto your toes, come down, and begin to shake. You want to be shaking from your core. It's roughly below your navel a little bit. It's called the Dantian in Chinese. And the goal is to make the motion as relaxed and continuous as possible. You want to continue scanning your body feeling while you shake. Try to sink your awareness and the feeling of your breath into your core. Relaxing the diaphragm, trying to relax the shoulders, using as little muscle tension in the legs as possible. At the beginning, you'll feel rather rigid, but as you continue with the practice, and this isn't just over the course of one day, this is over the course of weeks or months, you will feel more and more fluid. The metaphor they use to describe this is that of ice melting. So when you're rigid, when you have these fixed, tight areas, it feels like ice. And then as you shake, as you breathe, as you bring the light of your awareness to those areas, they can begin to relax. They'll start to change shape. This is ice melting into water. And then as you follow those areas as they change shape, as they connect to other areas, eventually you'll have a feeling of openness and lightness, and that's like water vaporizing into gas. And that's pretty much the end goal of the shaking, is that you're trying to scan through your body, find tight, heavy, uncomfortable areas. Just use the relaxation of the shaking, the breathing, the awareness to melt those areas, to relax those areas. Then follow the change and ultimately reach a state of openness, a tong, or connection. Flow. Always be bringing your awareness back to this area. If you scan through the body, make sure that you're constantly coming back to the core. Everything connects to to the core. And then when you're done with the shaking, it can be for 5 minutes, 10 minutes, it can be up to 40 minutes or an hour. You want to slowly come to rest the way a ball bouncing on the ground comes to rest. You want to let the shake, the amplitude diminish. Try to keep feeling the vibrations of the shake, even as the amplitude grows towards zero. And then you end the way you started. Again, take a chance to feel your body. Scan through it. Feel the differences from when you started. And then afterwards, you can do a little self-massage. You can do the just rubbing, padding, do yoga, do another exercise, go for a run. The shaking is a good kind of foundational warm-up exercise for other exercises as well.